We're going to start then with the final review of the thesis statement. This here, right. There is a definition of the of what a thesis statement is, and I think that most of you understand what it is, but I'm going to go through it anyway. A thesis statement is one sentence that should be in your introductory paragraph. It is very important to bear that in mind, because if you write the thesis statement in the second paragraph, that would be incorrect. So the thesis statement is like a summary of the main point of your essay, right? And also, you have to show your position in relation to the topic, right? The thesis statement is like the introduction for the reader. It's like an invitation for the reader to continue reading the rest of the essay, right? The easiest way to start with our thesis statement is to read the topic or the prompt and change the topic and turn it in, into a question, right? This then you have to answer the question, right? And when you answer the question, you have to show your position as well. In order to write a clear answer, you need to understand the kind of question you are asking, right? Most type of questions fall into five different categories. And the first, I'm going to provide some particular examples. For example, if the topic is divorce, the question might be, does divorce cause serious problems for the children? That would be a kind of fact claim, right? Because it might be false or it might be true. A second question might be, what is domestic violence? In this case, we are dealing with a definition, right? A third question, what are the causes of divorce? In this case, we are talking about cause. Then, how important is it for couples to avoid divorce? This is related to value. And finally, we have a proposal, a proposition that is a kind of solution. What can you do to make your marriage divorce-proof? So in this case, you can identify clearly the kind of questions that you are asking when you transform the prompt into a question. And in that way, you can then write your thesis statement. The answer to your thesis statement would be then the thesis statement itself. For example, your question often can be the title of your paper, or it can be the first line of the introduction, right? Your answer to this question is your thesis. For example, if the question is, what is the best way to make your marriage divorce-proof? And the answer would be, the most important way to make your marriage divorce-proof is to make sure you have carefully prepared for that commitment, all right? So the question would be probably an introduction for your paragraph, like that, like a topic sentence, but the answer would be your thesis statement, right? In answer to the question, you can also tell the reader the focus of your paper. And for example, you let the reader know you are focusing on the preparation for your marriage in order to prevent divorce. In this case, you are taking a position in favor of marriage, right? Okay. Yeah, we have a second type of strategy. I think this is stronger than the first one, and it can be more convincing. Right. And so, this is called refute objection. Another way to craft a thesis statement is to state one side of the argument and present a refuting statement. Let's see the example. Why some people think there is no way to divorce proof your marriage, studies have shown that there are fewer divorces when people carefully prepare for that commitment. Can you see that in this case, you, in a way, you acknowledge that there are people who think that there is no evidence that a marriage will be forever, right? So before taking a position, I advise that you carry out some research in order to collect some evidence to support your position, right? Then we have a third strategy that is called roadmap. An additional way to make a strong thesis is to do a roadmap, okay, which tells you, or which tells the reader in a few words, the three or more main points that you will cover. Let's see an example in relation to the same topic, divorce, right? Why some people think there is no way to divorce proof your marriage? Studies have shown that there are fewer divorces when people carefully prepare for that commitment by taking time to get to know the other person before becoming engaged, by spending time with another's family and friends, by talking about hot button issues like finances, and by getting extensive premarital counseling. I think this is much clearer than the previous one, the first strategy that was dealing with writing a question and then providing an answer, because in this strategy, you are not only giving an answer to the question, you are also presenting clear evidence that will support your argument, right? All right, let's move on then to the first paragraph in detail. Let's suppose that you have written your thesis statement. It is much better to prepare your thesis statement and then prepare the first paragraph in order to make it coherent, okay, and more logical, all right? How you can start your argumentative essay? First of all, we're going to... The introductory paragraph should be crafted around your thesis statement. This is very important. It is a must that you have your thesis statement before you prepare your the first paragraph, right? Provide a background information needed to understand your argument and presenting pieces of evidence that back up your argument. The first sentence should be like a hook, right? You can use fact or a statistic, a quote, a personal anecdote, or through a thought-provoking question. So the first sentence is used to call the reader's attention and to invite the reader to read the rest of the essay. So if you don't have a good paragraph, introductory paragraph, probably the reader will not be encouraged to move on with the rest of the essay. When you write the first paragraph, you have then to provide some background. You start with a hook, and then you provide some background or context, okay? And the context deals with the situation, what is going on with the situation, okay? What are the events that lead you to your argument? And why should people care? Give enough background on the topic that the reader can understand your argument. Nothing more and nothing less. So it is very important that you consider these questions at the moment you start writing the first paragraph, right? And this should be done during the pre-writing activity when you prepare your outline. So these questions will guide you through the first paragraph in a clear way, And then the last part of the introductory paragraph is for your thesis statement, right? So it's like a skeleton. You start with a hook, that would be the topic sentence, and then you prepare the context, and then you write your thesis statement in a way.